So my session at Expo was cannabis and your perioperative patient. So as many of you may have noticed, both recreational and medicinal cannabis are available now in many, many states. The presentation focused on how it impacts your patient and what you need to be aware of in caring for these patients and screening them. What I want you to take away from this session is what you need to do about the potential patient that has used cannabis. You know, you may need increased sedation in order to keep that patient down. Even for procedures such as endoscopy, they may require a little more. Also, their pain levels tend to be higher if they're a chronic cannabis user. And that's important to note postoperatively. You know, what you may give them, say, you know, ibuprofen, Tylenol is not gonna cut it maybe for these patients. If they consume cannabis on the day of surgery, they might be impaired. Can they really legally sign that consent if they're impaired? Probably not. You want to find out, A, when they last consumed cannabis, how they consumed it, what was the route? Because there's different routes of absorption. How frequent they use cannabis. That's going to tell you whether or not they're a chronic cannabis user. If you don't have any policies in your facility, talk to your anesthesia team. Ask them how they kind of look at patients who might be potential cannabis users, much like they would smoking or illegal drug use. But recognize again, cannabis is everywhere. Whether or not it's legal in your state, be it medicinally or recreationally, and recognize that it may affect your patient.